So we'll talk about sizes of things in the solar system in this video. So here is a graphic that shows the proper relative sizes of the planets and the sun. And it looks sort of like a PowerPoint template, but if you look all the way over at the left, that's the sun right there. Okay, so you can't even fit the sun on this slide or on this one graphic. It's too big to see the full circle of the sun. And then as you go out, you start from the inner planets going to the outer planets, as shown by that arrow there. And look how big the sun is. Everything inside that big circle, there's the sun. Can't even fit it on the video, as I said. And then we start to look at the planets now. There's Mercury, little dot right there. Venus is the next one right there. And this Earth, look how similar Venus and Earth are in size. Very similar in size. And then there's Mars there, about half the size of the Earth, so it's a little bit smaller, this planet we all want to get to, kind of small. And these inner planets are called the terrestrial planets because they're all made out of rocks, hard rocks and lava and things like that. Then we get to the outer planets. They're the gas giants, so-called: Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Very large planets made out of gas, nothing solid to stand on or go by there at all. And there's a line that sort of divides them, which you can think of, the rocky planets and then the gas giants. And it definitely sort of divides the solar system in two. There's just very distinct differences between the planets there. But the distances are just not possible to capture on this graph. In other words, on this video, this view here. In other words, the distances between the planets and the sizes are just impossible to capture in one graphic. So coming up is a video I have. Well, before I do that, if you have trouble sort of figuring out what an AU is, 93 million miles, almost impossible sort of to comprehend such large numbers. Well, I got something for you. Got something you can use to remember 93 million miles, have a feeling for what 93 million miles is. CVS receipts. I got this receipt when I ordered just one pack of gum, bought one pack of gum. That's the receipt I got. And it turns out that CVS receipts are very useful for estimating AU. So if you put 8 of these CVS receipts together, that'll be approximately the distance between the Earth and the Sun, 93 million miles. Isn't that fantastic? Ha ha ha. See, this is a more realistic view here. That's just sort of a plastic globe. There's about 1 million of those little pellets inside of there. That's sort of the way the Sun would look for the transparent globe, and the Earth would be all those little blue balls in between there. That's actually a realistic scale right there. So that's sort of the sizes that we're talking about. About 1 million Earths would fit in there. But it's still hard to get a grasp on what these sizes are. So take a look at this silent video here. It'll scroll through a bunch of different sizes. So we'll start with our moon, which is sort of large for a moon. There's the planet Mercury, that little small dot I showed you next to the sun. Mars, about half the size of the Earth. Here comes Venus and the Earth, about the same size. Sometimes they're called sister planets. But then from Earth, look at Neptune, just huge. And look at how Earth just quickly disappears from all consideration of size. We are so tiny compared to these planets. There's Jupiter. Look at the Sun. We're just done. As far as the Earth goes, not even on the scale anymore. Sirius is a relatively large, bright star in the sky. Pollux, we'll talk about Pollux soon in the night sky. Arcturus, we'll talk about Arcturus soon in the night sky. Aldebaran. Rigel, we'll talk about Rigel soon. It's in the foot of Orion. I don't know much about that one. Antares, we'll talk about Antares. That'll come up in our night sky discussion. I don't know much about that one either. But look at where the Earth, how the Earth has just gone from view.